Which does not kill me, can only make me stronger. For real. I don't see why everybody feel as though they gotta tell me how to live my life. You know? Let me live, baby. Let me live.
Come on, yep, come on.
I'm allergic to flowers.
I remember that for your birthday.
Nigga, fuck you.
Push you down the flower bed.
And whatever. So I want to thank you guys for tuning in to this week's episode of Hostially Awkward. As usual, I am joined by my co-host, Heartbreak Fresh. Oh, wait. We ain't Heartbreak Fresh no more. We going to get on that in a minute. That ain't Heartbreak Fresh no more.
That certified lover boy.
Right. And Mr. Tone Deaf, both of the Deaf Fresh Show. And Mr. Versace on the flow.
Hey, talk about it.
Dog, you I'm mad at you, dog.
Yeah, we told him he was late because he was taking seductive selfies with his fingers in his mouth.
And I was on time as a motherfucker, man.
You wasn't.
We walked in here together.
That's because nobody felt like coming back upstairs to let you in, so we waited till you got here.
Oh.
That's actually kind of smart.
Yeah.
That is smart.
I'm like, bro, I'm not on that type of time today. I had a long weekend.
Hey, that's what we need, bro. We need a Versace on the floor button.
How about no?
Yeah. That's nice, though.
You sound like how about Jimmy fucking no?
Like, when you drop a gym, right. When you drop a gym, we could just hit Versace on the floor.
And it's like, y'all been saying that so much. Like, I've never listened to the song. I've never heard the song.
I don't even really like the song.
Like, I know the song exists.
But Monte made it cool when he said it. Like,
don't tell that nigga he made something cool. He
shout out to him for that.
Yeah, but how was everybody's weekend?
I had to work.
My weekend was cool. I was at work for most of it. Why everybody looking at me? How was your weekend?
Oh, that was it.
We want to know how your weekend was, my nigga.
Yeah, I want to know about the full weekend.
I don't want to hear about.
We can go shoe shopping, and then you know, never mind. I'm gonna go on a date weekend. Let's talk about it.
You walked into that one,
yeah.
Bro.
You waddled right into that one.
Like if you would have just answered the original question,
I did.
Why you look dumbfounded?
I've been drinking, bitch.
No, that ain't the reason. You living off love. Look at you.
My weekend was very nice. Juan went on a date this weekend.
Hey.
It's not unusual.
Oh, my.
By anyone.
And we went to a date. Appreciate you. We went to the Cheesecake Factory.
Okay. Nice first date.
Never going back again.
Real low key. Real.
Real expensive.
Not dating nowadays, kind of. Man, pricey period
for that shit.
Was the date $200?
Hell no.
Okay, so it wasn't pricey then.
Bro, you good?
Especially what you eating?
Because you can go to Papa. You can go to Papa.
Bro, you know what, Loki? I was so high I couldn't eat.
But no, I told you like those are standard prices for like the stuff that you were naming off. I'm like, that's pretty standard.
Yeah, that's pretty standard, boys.
That's not you've been out the game.
It's not even that he's been out the game for a while. It's the fact he don't order nothing but chicken tenders and fries wherever we go.
That's true.
We can go to Shea Marie and this nigga will see if they got some fucking chicken tenders and fries.
You're going to have to grow out of that.
We go to Mexican restaurant. You know what he orders? Chicken wings and fries.
They got fries at Mexican restaurant?
Hey, them shit slapping though. You was eating them chicken wings we brought back to the studio that day. Them motherfuckers fire.
That was from the Mexican spot. Really?
Yeah. You gotta expand your palate though, bro.
Yeah, you do.
There's many different ways
to eat a potato.
Expand your palate just a bit. But come on, and continue. Proceed.
I did. So, like, because the look she gave me when I was looking for, like, the french fries on the menu, like, I was like, oh, okay.
You almost fucked up the
day. Don't God, like, she was an utter, like, french fries. Like, you know where we could have went for french fries? It's like, you got a point. I'll find something that. Because, like, man, half the motherfucking menu, maybe because I was high and the light is muted, but I'm like, I can't see this shit. I don't know what's going on.
And you're lactose intolerant.
That's another thing, too. So you got to kind
of. Don't eat cheese. You lactose intolerant.
Yeah,
so.
That right there, that's confusing. You went to Cheesecake Factory, but you can't eat half the shit on the menu.
Cheesecake Factory food really nasty, too. I'm surprised you went there.
He had never been there before. That was a suggestion.
That's how they got there.
Cause I had never, cause me, cause
I
said,
shared a stat.
She shared a stat. It was like I had never been to Cheesecake Factory, and I commented, I was like, "Shit, we never." So I never had the desire to just go.
Yeah. That was me and Mar's first date, Cheesecake Factory.
And then after going, it's just a bougie version of Applebee's.
Yes,
it is. It's really swanky Applebee's.
Because the only thing
food
that
is frozen and prepared in a microwave is.
Yeah. I mean, the strawberry lemonade was fire.
Strawberry lemonade is fire, period. You could have got one from Wendy's, but proceed.
Big facts.
Absolutely.
Like, it basically sounded like you wanted, the way you made that order, you basically wanted to order Wendy's there.
I mean, the chicken, from what
I don't want to hear about the food. I want to hear about your interaction with little baby.
Oh, we was cool. You know, we bonded.
Maybe. Hand me the pepper towel.
I feel like maybe we bonded because.
It's just in, like, your way and shit.
I mean, we both, you know, smoke weed, so that's a good thing.
That's right up your alley.
That was the highlight of your day.
Now,
right there.
If she can get down on Killer Instinct, you might be on to something.
That's a fact. I don't know if I can get little baby to play Mortal Kombat with me.
You never know, bro.
Did you ask?
No.
You got to, like, weasel that into the conversation. Right. Like, so.
She know I like video games.
So let me ask you a question, Juan.
What's up?
Because this is going to be a completely different kind of scenario for you. Because she got a shorty.
Right.
You,
I got kids, too.
Real ass nigga who finally admitted that shit. But are you
ready? I had to help my kid pee before I left the house.
I, too. Bad duties.
See, we got people in the comments saying that they love Cheesecake Factory. Like, it wasn't, I didn't like it.
Because y'all eat anything.
That, the nerve.
After the... Ooh, hi too. I see where you went. And it came out so
very well played.
That was a joker.
Big
no,
joker.
Like the stuff that I like wasn't even entrees. It was the appetizers, like the buffalo blast that they have, like the little shredded buffalo chicken.
You like that shit?
Yeah, Monte said that shit in the group chat. He was like, "Damn, I should have put you on the buffalo blast."
See, and I ain't see like those are good. And then I like they little spinach and artichoke and crab, whatever that is. But those are both appetizers. But everything else, like I didn't like the entrees. Monte talking about some hit the fatality button.
He's like, never mind.
Right. But yeah, so
you must be in the group.
So what's up?
Yeah, because I can't see.
Yeah, if it says Facebook user, they're in the group.
Okay. All right.
Compared to being on one of the pages.
Well, in conclusion. Will there be yourself going on another one?
Second date?
Yeah, definitely go for the second.
Have y'all started talking about a second date, or y'all just, you know,
we ain't specifically
smoothing out the edges?
Them,
but you know, right, is it?
I'm pretty sure. It's
are you going?
Was it anything that you didn't like? Anything you didn't like about it besides
bill.
The food?
The
don't say nothing about and the bill with your cheap ass.
I'm not, no
food and bill. I don't want to hear about.
I'm not cheap. First of all, anybody who knows me know I'm not fucking cheap. It's just. The quality of what I paid for
wasn't it wasn't worth what
that shit wasn't worth what I paid.
I get
that's
you.
My point.
Yeah, because that's not what I want to hear about. Right. I want to hear, is there anything else you didn't like about the date?
No, everything was cool.
Everything was cool. She nice looking.
You gonna do more? Of
did you put on? Did you put on some smell good? Make your hair look all right?
Of course.
You hit her with that fat mac and did
you?
Know
what I'm all I right. Got the bourbon body wash. I got a little bourbon. Ooh, cologne.
Not the bourbon.
Ooh, I was out.
You know you did.
I feel like everybody. in our family got the bourbon.
I got to re up. I'm down to my last bottle.
Yeah, I did. I just.
Then you know what always helps when you smell like a little bag.
Now I have a question. That it has nothing to do with anyone else. I just want to know because it's just I know how the driver's head thing went. When she picked you up for the date, was it like awkward getting in the car? Or does she have a nice size vehicle?
She got a truck.
Oh,
you see?
Come on. Come on.
Nigga.
We keeping this one.
Woo.
By all means necessary. We keeping this one. Because you slid right in the truck like a player.
It was roomy.
Now,
stretched
now.
Legs.
You ain't had to suck your stomach in or nothing.
I see what kind of night this is going to be.
We just happy for you, bro. That's all.
That nigga said,
you been in a serious
you
drought.
Slid in there like a player.
Monte said, SUV, she was prepared.
Woo.
How do I get out this family?
You don't. Blood in, blood out.
Hey, look,
by honor.
As long as she was willing, you know, if she was feeling you enough, she showed up in the company van. It didn't matter. As long as y'all got there.
Right. Long as y'all went, you know what? Long as y'all went out and had a good time, man.
And, you know, and it makes me mad because it's like, Juan deserves.
He does.
This. And had he listened to us and blocked that raspy voice wench a long ass time ago, he probably could have been had some dates and shit like
this.
You
know what, though? I will say everything happens the way it's supposed to.
Big facts.
This is happening right now because it was supposed to. He didn't block that rancid mouth ass bitch when we told him to, maybe because he wasn't supposed to yet.
She also told me she hate my nickname, too. So.
She what? She hates what?
She hates my nickname.
Heartbreak Fresh.
Heartbreak Fresh.
Yeah, see, we.
That's why
we.
So,
you, that's why you finna
do. Do we retire that this evening?
This evening?
This evening. Because I won't.
Okay, you ain't got to officially retire the jersey because y'all ain't official yet. Just fold it up a little bit and sit it on a gamer chair.
Put it in your sock drawer. But for right now, Heartbreak Fresh is.
Fatality.
Yeah, that motherfucker's gone.
It's dead.
Yeah. Shout out to that, man.
You don't wear
that heart attack fresh.
To the show.
Going nowhere for a while.
I'm trying to sneak it in.
I can't wear that, man.
You can't sneak it in the show, bro.
You caught that.
I did.
I don't even know what you said, but I know you're terrible.
Very nice.
He ain't shit.
Very nice.
I'm not putting that up there.
You should.
No.
Because it's true. It's a fact.
No.
What does it say?
This is what it says.
Because you asked for it.
Wait, what was it?
Never. Fuck.
Damn, Monte caught it too.
What the fuck? Never. Heart attack, fresh, funny as a bitch.
I be giving bitches heart attacks, man. What else?
I've been cooking with gas today.
This is nuts.
This is going to be a good show tonight, man.
Oh, yeah, because I'm relaxed as a motherfucker after the weekend I had. So,
oh, boy. We right into it?
We right into it.
You swagway that right into that. You walked me right into this.
I didn't know such
you
thing.
You did.
No, so... I did some interesting content Thursday night. I don't know why the fuck we did this on a Thursday night instead of waiting until Friday, like for the actual weekend when everybody was off.
That thing Thursday, perhaps?
That's pretty much what the fuck it was.
Is that the hashtag on the video?
Now, I haven't even started.
Very nice.
Hey, Courtney Boo. Make sure you check because, you know, I got you. No, that's my little.
She freaking late too.
That's because
that's Courtney.
That tone horrible.
You was pushing stuff, so I was like, okay, you got it then.
Hey man, why
that was an accident.
Hey,
take that
y'all
up.
Go and make sure y'all names are certified. I'm sick of looking at Facebook user.
That's because Tone said it's because they in the group.
They in the group. They got to click. They got to click that little link to approve it. Yeah.
And click the goddamn StreamYard link.
Yeah, because I don't know who's who. I don't see no pictures.
Press the goddamn button.
No name.
Anytime I see my real name, I know who it is.
I didn't forget to take it down. It was just funny up there. But yeah, so I did a foursome video for OnlyFans.
Gotta get your groove.
And groove we motherfucking did. Let's groove tonight.
Don't do too much.
Though I did a lot.
So the participants in this battle royale.
This lumberjack ass man.
Right.
It was
championship scramble.
It was more like a mixed tag.
Oh, so it was two dudes, two chicks?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, that might not work.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I was wondering.
Ah, you thought it was a full sausage party? No.
No, I thought it might have been four bitches. I don't know.
No.
You like bitches.
Yeah, but she liked to gargle some balls every so often.
You feel so uncomfortable saying
that. I did. Like, it hurt me. Like, on one hand, bro, I'd be so happy for her doing whatever she want to do. And then on the second hand, it's like, somebody face fucked your sister. Like, come on, man.
Yeah, stay off Twitter because it's definitely a double.
And
Facebook
then when
video.
I see Buddy in the grocery store, I be wanting to push him down. Like,
he's so tiny.
That's why when I see like a promo stat and too many comments, I was like, you know what? I'm gonna slide on.
You know what? I lost myself the other day. A nigga commented on her profile like something about her titties or something. And
right,
I commented.
As soon
like,
as he said DT, I got the fuck out of Dodge. Yeah. Because I already knew what was coming.
Yeah. And he be in the comments too. Like, bro, pretty cool. I don't know. Just that moment, I wasn't with that shit.
Is that the new mix tag? I thought the old ones, they used to get the punch bitches and shit. They used to just run out the ring in time. Because I'm pretty sure I saw China fighting with some niggas.
China don't count.
Though. Wait, what? Yeah,
okay.
What are we? What?
I was reading Monte's comment. He said it. Monte said if it's mixed tag, that means it's women on women and men on men.
Oh, so y'all had like an intergender match.
Yeah. So it was.
Or was it dude on dude?
No.
No. You know, sexuality is a spectrum.
It is.
It's a big spectrum.
No, you know, I don't judge it. It's just that's not what we was on. No.
If you are having a threesome and it's you and two dudes, which technically probably a train. And folks is
cramming. It's not technically a trick.
If he cramming you and then you got like a face full of nuts and he reach over and kiss dude, are we still partying here?
Why are you so graphic, first of all?
Wait.
I'm just asking.
Wait a minute. The fact that you can stomach that.
I was like, why is that so graphical?
Like he leaned over and got him some sugar.
What are you talking,
bro? Stop watching HBO Max.
Hold on, Tone. Hold on, I got it.
That sounds like an episode of Game of
Thrones. Are we banned places? It say can't post comments to some destinations. What the fuck we do?
Oh, it always.
I'm just. You're right, bro.
Right, but
you're right. And the some question, sugar. And the question that I had, that I asked in the group, I forgot what I asked him in the group.
Some goofball shit.
It was funny though.
Bro,
some sugar, bro.
I closed the phone. I closed the phone so fast.
He getting his smooch. I don't fucking know, bro.
Why let it go, bro?
They're just staring at each other. I don't.
Why is your mind here?
When you run a train, though, you and the other nigga do not make eye contact.
See, he's been in this situation.
When you run in the train, y'all not even doing it at the same time. It's one after the other.
No,
that's a typical train.
What?
There's trains.
Well,
the ones
I had, like,
and then there's the one with,
and if you're in the same room with a nigga, this is not a train, this is a threesome.
Again, because
I've had it wrong all these years.
You have. I've given a definition on the show multiple times. So
give yourself a fatality, bro. You a freak.
What the fuck?
You a wild nigga.
I am.
So before we get to your ladder match. All this time I've been defining it wrong.
Yes.
Yeah, bro,
a lot of people have.
Because the first one we had, like, she was sucking my dick and then bro was pounding her. And then we just switched.
Yeah, you're having a threesome.
So,
this is not a triangle.
And then when we used to be at the Ocho.
Right.
Clearly just, you know.
Now, see,
head to tail.
And like I said, like I've defined it on Facebook and on this show multiple times. So for those who are not familiar or who are just tuning in, I am going to break these things down for you. Now, a threesome is three people at the same time, regardless of gender. It does not matter if it's all women, all men, two women, and one man, two men, one woman. It's three people. At the same time.
You know why?
A train is multiple people taking turns to fuck one person.
And I've never done that.
Yeah, that's what a train is. And a gangbang is a group of people fucking one person.
Yeah. Like,
and then an orgy is a group of people getting busy with each other.
Like Debbie does Debbie 500 or whatever when the white bitches be
Dallas.
Yeah, that kind of shit.
So like, you know, she got a dick here, she got two in her hands, she got one in her mouth, some balls on her forehead, all of that shit. Like that is
that
a gangbang.
Be looking real wild.
That's a gangbang.
You need an ice pack for that.
But you know, some niggas out here playing Madden and shit, and then when dog come out, like, all right, bro, it's on you. That's a train. You're taking turns.
The reason I never called mine a threesome is because there was no way I was interacting with bro. Like, that's why I thought it was just a train. But we, you know, you never make eye contact with a nigga. It's kind of like telekinesis. You just know what to do. Like, don't look at me, bro. Don't trip over my foot or none of that shit, because then there's going to be a fight in there.
Yeah.
Wow. The more you know.
Yeah, because even if
now I feel like we need that.
It took me 20 years to notice.
It's okay,
bro. No, 21, because I had my first threesome at 16.
You're a wild nigga.
Yeah. We used to have a nasty channel, bro.
Like, I'm not judging.
No, I mean, hey, I don't give a fuck about you.
Merriam-Webster, threesome, noun. Definition one, a group of three persons or things, a trio. Two, a golf match in which one person plays his or her ball against the ball of two others playing each stroke.
What are we talking about?
Right, like where we at?
That sounds kinky too.
That's a golf match. Kinky. I'm
a golf match.
Might want to lower the lights in here.
A sexual encounter involving three people.
Oh, a threesome calls would be a golf thing?
Yeah, it's a golf match in which one person plays his or her ball against the ball of two others playing each stroke alternately.
Bruh, that sounds wild as fuck. What about this
one? Nah, I'm good on those. So, you ever been in any Mexican standoffs, Tom?
I've done a couple of Mexican
standoffs. A Mexican standoff, when I hear that sexually in my head, it's like everybody got their dick pointed at each other.
Yo,
like every whoever
time,
nut on
every
each
time
other
I hear Mexican standoff, I think of.
That's really where we got it from, that and wrestling.
What is that?
The three-way dance.
Basically, just a threesome then?
Yeah.
Okay.
But I guess
you are very welcome.
But now that she put that in there, she didn't fuck it up.
I guess if you do it with a Mexican, it's considered a Mexican standoff.
No. So anyway,
south of the border.
You know, we are in this hotel room, and I feel like we have to do it over. Not because the chemistry was off. Like these are people who I've worked with all three of them before. Like me and her, we always do our girl stuff. We, you know, slut niggas out together. Like that's my go to. And with the guys, I've worked with them individually and together, you know, whether it was a threesome with her or a threesome with them too. Like, you know, I've done it all. But the room that he got, it was, for me, it wasn't big enough, like, for our setup and shit. Like, everybody's a content creator. So we all have our ring lights and all of this shit. Like, it's just, you know, and it's like,
equipment
you don't,
everywhere.
Right. You don't want to set up your equipment to block somebody else's equipment, but then you don't want to set it up at an angle where you can see everybody else's shit. So it was just, it wasn't enough room for me.
Y'all need to, no, you can't do that.
You got to have all
If they angles. All create content, bro, they all need their own setup.
We are all our own, want to be our own point
and
of focus.
I know,
and
I
our
see,
shit.
I see where you're going. You know, like, just send it to me, but. You know, who really
we do,
go?
But we still do though. We swap, we content swap. So there may be certain things like it's four
y'all
different
need,
angles.
Y'all need a cameraman for that.
I told Mimi I would be a cameraman, but then I don't think she would trust me because I probably hit little dog and that shit. Like, don't do that to her, bro. Like, what did you do? Don't do that to her.
You be ramming too hard, so you
yeah, bro. You not funny. Yeah, my sister Pam. What's wrong with you?
Hey, you imagine on a downstroke somebody punching your kidney?
Yeah, like what the fuck you think? No, don't be grabbing her hair like that, fam.
Nah, but like, so I know like listeners and shit, like they be y'all don't want to hear details, but they do. So you know, whatever. I'm gonna go
piss. I've already checked out.
Yeah, so we finna talk about the weather until he come back because I'm helping on making him uncomfortable tonight. Go ahead and pee, bro.
Or piss yourself.
Get out of the way. All
right. You gonna go fry pork chops?
You gotta chill, Juan.
What did I do?
You gotta chill, Faye.
Dev said, so you gonna fight a naked nigga?
I'm not. That's why I don't wanna be the cameraman.
That's terrible, dog.
No, but it was really, really nice to be able to be in that environment and, you know, be 100% comfortable. Nothing was weird. You know, we
is
had
that
our little
safe space.
That is.
That's
but
four people.
Just the whole.
No, just who I was with.
Creating the content in general, yeah. You know,
because one of the guys I had just recorded with him on Tuesday.
God, damn.
So we did our own stuff on Tuesday. And then Thursday was the group thing that we did.
It's like a little community.
Yeah. You know, I deal with the same people, and it's like, and it's nice because, like I said, people will look at it like, "Oh my God, it was four of you at the same time," but it's like,
it's the same four you've been dealing with.
We all have our test results. Who are you fucking up?
Right, you niggas out here.
Capital just, One, what's in you?
What's on your test results?
Yeah, but
judgmental bastards.
It was nice because there is, ladies, if you haven't experienced being in the 69 with another woman while getting pounded on from the back, 5 stars, highly recommended. Make sure you get into that, especially when the other dude comes. So you're holding her legs up for her while she's getting pounded on. And then, you know, it's really business in the front, party in the back.
Like a mullet?
Yep. Because you're helping the people in front of you. You know, you keeping her legs out the way. So it's business in the front, but then there's a party in the back. Because you're sitting on her face, and then he like.
So is there like balls on your forehead?
No.
Okay.
No. I mean, because wow, that would be weird. The balls are underneath. So he would literally have to throw his balls around in order for them to go on my forehead, seeing how I was on top.
Oh, I was like, I didn't know you was on top. I didn't know.
Well, why are you so
I just said tonight? I was helping hold her legs up. See, you don't listen.
Yeah. Who wants to listen to this?
You keep asking the questions.
I do it for the listeners, bro. I have to. Somebody's got to.
My dick.
Just let her explain the story.
So Kayla asked, she said, how the fuck do you recover after that? You have an aftercare routine. You know, there was nothing really to recover from aside of the fact that I had to go to work that next morning and I was tired as a motherfucker. Like, I didn't want to get out of my hotel bed that next day.
You got to relax, bro.
What else? What,
so somebody had hair on it. Where did you get this from?
Maybe
who said anything about somebody having hair on their ass?
He's reading out the same book.
Was there any weird back shot wind going on?
Oh, no, we don't play that.
Okay.
No. We don't play
that. What did I call it the other day? Back that ass up wind?
No, we don't play that around this podcast.
That is the way to end the party.
I mean, because not even the guys had one. Because the way that we were positioned. Because it was a nice little setup. Like I'm saying, like, we were both with our heads at the foot of the bed, and then they stood up like over us and did like the little froggy hop to face fuck. It was nice. And even with them being guys, there was no weird booty wind. Fam, they are very hygienic. That's why I love working with them. Like, they are so clean.
You gotta get over it.
I'm talking to them. They wanted the details.
If they want the details, they should subscribe.
Oh, he said he came back and heard something like about a mullet. That's
like
why
the
he
rest
thought
of the freaks
that it was.
He heard party in the back or some shit.
Yeah,
he thought you was talking about a mullet.
Nah, nobody had an ass mullet.
Mullet ass hair. Like that.
That's got to be more.
You know how much hair that would be?
Yes.
Wow.
That's a whole shot.
Yeah. It's
too much. I'm not fucking with no nigga with no whole Khal Drogo ponytail.
It's like getting on peanut his ass on a shag carpet.
Mm-mm. Yeah, but that was fun. Friday, I don't think I did anything the rest of the weekend. Shit, I was recovering. I had to go to work Friday. Saturday, didn't do anything. Sunday, I was drunk all day long. Sunday, I went to brunch at brunch with Denise and had bottomless mimosas.
Cracker.
Yeah, and then after that, I ended up going on a random date night trip to Chicago. Like, we was just supposed to be going to have some drinks. And as soon as he picked me up, we hopped right on the fucking E-Way and we just went to Chicago. So we went to a strip club down there and hit the casino for a bit before went home and got busy. Well, we went and checked into a hotel because we knew we wasn't going to make it home. And then we ended up checking out, like, we were supposed to leave like first thing in the morning. I don't think we left until like damn near 11. So I just told my boss I had to bubble gut. Shit wasn't working right, and I'd be in later that afternoon.
Hey, whatever works.
Hey, like, look, first of all, everybody knows that I hadn't been eating red meat. So who knows? Right. On that date night, he could have got me a steak, and then all of a sudden things didn't agree with me. But yeah, so. We'll see how that goes. We're planning something else. We'll see if it actually, it'll be like probably spur of the moment whirlwind like we just did. But
did y'all, we always know, have did y'all like plan this plan? Or this like be spur of the moment when y'all get together?
No, we just, whenever we together, like our vibe is just, no matter what we do together, we always have fucking fun. Like, cause sometimes we'll just get in the car, drive all the way down, you know, Kenosha, Racing, whatever.
Yo, chick or
no? And then we'll come back. But no, but dude, that wasn't something that we just planned. It just happened. Then because of that, like I said, we was like, all right, but we go down here. You know, we'll probably leave like 2-3 or whatever, because you got to work in the morning. I got to get, you know, my shit together, whatever. But then we ended up staying. And that is such a hard thing with us, because we do not be responsible, man. Like, when we link up, we are not responsible. We will be like, fuck everything. So toxic.
Gotta get your groove.
Yeah.
We're not mad at you.
I ain't mad at that.
But it's only that one, though.
Have fun.
It's nobody else.
We've known that for years.
Yeah, like whenever we link up, it'd be like, I know I gotta be at work at 8, and I clearly see that this clock say 7:59, and we both just be looking at each other like,
yeah, fuck it. Yeah,
we've done that so many times.
16 people watching today.
Yeah, hey, so many times.
They heard Juan had a date and everybody wanted to hear.
Yeah.
But yeah.
That's big news.
No,
man.
For real, dog. It's been that up in numbers ever since we talked about your date.
It's big news, bro. You've been heartbreak fresh for the, you know, since I came on the show, at least.
6 months.
Yeah.
Wow.
You've been here that long?
Has it been?
How the fuck I let you get past your probation period?
I don't know. It started with the Brocially Awkward episode, and then I begged to come on this. Like, just me, and then, you know, rest is history.
It's like when you feed a stray cat. Right. It just
come back.
I know I'm talking about since we've been here. I don't know how I let him pass his probation period.
Because he started bringing liquor?
Yep, that's what got you in the beginning.
Yeah.
And look, I know, and look what happened now.
I know how to work a room, bitch.
That'd be sashaying. Swaying his hips really about.
Are we done with the foursome?
Y'all want to talk about this more?
No.
All right.
Just making sure you're done.
Yes, I'm done. Unless anybody has questions. If they have questions,
y'all don't
gladly answer.
Tone, don't put them comments. She
got I can see them myself.
Right. She got them herself. Fuck. I got to put them up.
I can definitely see them.
Monte told me quit asking questions.
Yeah. He was right. He was right.
So
I'm making it interesting for the listeners, man. Gotta create the content, bro.
You asking what if two niggas kissed was way beyond.
That nigga said, give me some sugar.
Give me some sugar. Like,
but that's a scenario.
Hey, bro, give me some smooches. Give me the luscious. Like, come on, bro.
Give me the luscious, dog. Pause. Big pause. I'm just saying, like, you know, some shit be unspoken. Like, what if folks just he feeling it?
What do you do? I guess that was pretty much a good question. If you doing two males, you know, whatever.
You look up and now they
you happen to like look up and they tongue kissing. Like, what?
Right.
What do you do at that moment?
They're playing full blown taco.
I don't know. Like, I can't say that.
Do you feel like uncomfortable or you just probably roll with it?
No, I think I would feel uncomfortable just because it caught me off guard. Like, that wasn't something that was discussed.
Or
ahead
what
of
if,
time.
Like,
you know,
you run to the bathroom and come back and I'm not even finna say it, but you know what?
He waxing him.
They over there having a frying. This the
warm up.
He over here taking buddy buns.
Nah, bro, they got it.
You should go back in the bathroom, put the clothes on.
I'm not even finna try to double dutch and jump in that motherfucker. Like,
hey, you know what you got this, fam.
Like, clearly my job here is done.
Yeah.
The
niggas got impatient.
Then he expect you to go ask.
Yeah, I'm taking my time card and I'm punching right out.
You ain't wrong, bro. Because by then, it's smelling like ham in there, I'm sure.
Why does everything have to smell like ham to you?
Because everything smells like lunch meat, dog. Remember we used to be at Onyx? We walked past a few people and be like, smell like a deli in here.
You definitely told her she smelled like Cajun turkey.
Yeah.
Why did you? Dog, you got to chill.
Yeah.
Because turkey was the only lunch meat I would eat, and it had some spice to it when we walked past. So, Cajun turkey.
So, she smelled good to you.
Mm.
But you eat Cajun turkey.
I actually don't. I eat cracked pepper turkey.
Cajun turkey.
And at in the club, bro, I don't want to smell deli meat.
He got a point.
I want to smell perfume.
But you, thought it was okay to leave us at the door smelling yams. And
that was pure dressing and sage. Shout out to Granny for that. That dressing was slapping, bro. That, but my gut's been bad since 2012.
Karma.
What's today? The 17th?
Yes.
Yep.
Oh, shit. Okay. So, I have a story.
9 years ago today.
From Wednesday. Congrats.
Not really.
We have a story from Wednesday. The day before, you know, the foursome. So, Wednesday, I set up a quick little dick appointment for content. Because everything that I do is for content. I need you niggas to understand that if I decide that I am fucking with you on that level, it is strictly for content. It is not for recreational purposes. It's not because I just find you so fucking irresistible. It's because I need fucking content.
Is there anybody you fuck not for content?
Maybe one
person. Is there like one sexual experience that you just go have sex and you enjoy it? You don't need to record it.
One person.
Literally one. That's who I was just with last night when we ducked off.
Is this buddy you like you left and then came back for?
I don't know.
Or last week when you was like,
no,
it wasn't. When you was late?
Oh yeah. Yeah.
When you was late.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Do I know this? I know this person.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. But we
Mike's is hot.
We discuss it. But no. So Wednesday, you know.
Son of a bitch.
I hit this.
I bet I know who it
is. You're probably right. You are correct, sir.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah. I hit him up and I'm like, you know, so you fucking or not? Cause
are you rude?
Now.
Why do you act like that with people?
What?
We fucking or not. Why do people have to feel like a fucking object to you?
What the fuck are they supposed to feel like? Because I want to know how the fuck I'm supposed to address it.
Like, we fucking and all. Like, damn, man. Not gonna say I miss you or something.
Right. Not even I miss you.
You ain't sending an emoji or nothing.
Can you ask me how my day was?
Is you going to pull that dick out or no?
I said, you fucking or no? If you take all day, it's no, because I've been drinking and I'll go right to fuck the bed.
That's what you said.
How is that not?
You said that to somebody?
Yeah.
And he answers every time.
He just said, where you at?
He ain't got no self-respect. He needs value.
He don't, you know what? Value yourself.
He don't value himself.
Right.
No, it's, look, we know what it is. We don't fucking go out on dates. We don't watch movies and all of that shit. When we would, that's just what it is. It's content shit.
You are ruining these young men's lives.
No, I'm not.
They're not young, first of all.
Yeah. No, I'm not.
Honestly, I mean, these old niggas who ain't
okay. Mine. You know what though?
What bartender?
For all the
when Bob put it, that's what he's talking about.
Yeah,
no, I'm yeah. Right, yeah.
I fucked the bartender up.
Yeah. No, but I feel like there's no need for me to make it seem like it ain't what it is, and that's what kills me. Like, cause I just made a post earlier today, and I'm like, y'all are some of the most, man, I don't fuck with her, but yet you still fucking with her ass niggas I have ever seen. Like, there's bitches literally no reason. There's no reason to lie.
Bitches do it too.
And the dude commented and said, well, that's what y'all want to hear. Ain't no y'all, baby, because I'm honest about everything. You are not the only nigga in my rotation. If you don't answer and, you know, I give you a certain amount of time, like once I push send, that timer starts, and if you don't respond by then I'm moving on to the next.
Okay, so what's your timer? What's your grace period?
Yeah, usually about. I try to give like 30 minutes. I think it depends on how late it is.
30? A whole 30?
Depend on how late it is.
That's better than my job.
And I was giving 5 minutes back in my day.
Yeah.
No. You got 5 minutes to see this.
Cause see, I don't be. Cause once I send it, like I'd be doing other shit anyway. So even if they did respond within 5 minutes, I wouldn't see it right away anyway. So, if I go back and I see, you know, what's in it, but then they'll come back like, oh, what you want? Buddy, it's a wrap for that.
It's already over with.
It's a wrap for that. Like, because when I was at the hotel a couple weeks ago, one had fell asleep, and he knows me. Yeah, it is gracious. But he knows me. So when he woke up, he was like, I've been replaced yet. Because he knew.
Where's these niggas' but self-respect?
He, but he
they ain't
he,
got none.
Ain't got none
but
he,
bro, what is it?
He came though. And then as soon as he got there, the other dude responded like, hey, what's up? I'm like, damn, like.
What you do know, you do now?
Tortoise in the hair. Wow. Whoever got there.
Where's your self-respect, bro?
Who said it's not some they won't ask, right?
Have I been replaced? What?
Yeah, like, hey, no self-respect there.
I would have been like, which you know, where you no, at? No, I just seen this, where you at? The nigga said, have yeah, I been no, replaced?
But that's because when I sent the message that I told him, like, you already know that if you know whatever, like, I will definitely change the plans. Like, but I tell everybody that. Like, I will change
ain't
the plans.
Nobody coochie that good, bro.
So
right, to just let somebody talk to you.
Come like, on, man. I wish the fuck I would.
We not together, bro.
It doesn't matter. I'm duh.
We are not together.
That don't mean shit. That's even first more all, reason for me to be like, bitch, fuck you.
First
like,
of all, you want to know like why that? They don't? Because I'm the coolest bitch that they fuck with. I don't give them problems. I don't be trying to figure out who they fucking with. I don't be all in their goddamn business. I don't be all in their motherfucking mentions and likes and trying to whatever. Like when it's time for us to fuck around, then I will contact you. Outside of that, I leave you the fuck alone. They don't have problems out of me. That's probably why, because I like, well, shit, you know what?
Do you have anybody that you, like, you know, text, keep up conversation with? Or is it strictly, like, when you want to record some shit, listen, I need you to come over here. Or we need to link up so I can record this.
So I'm really not a small talk person.
I don't mean small talk, but just, like, you know how we talk in a group? Like, Juan was like, everybody okay today, woo, woo, woo. Is it somebody you'll hit like, hey, good morning, you good? Ooh. Or is it just,
no, like,
listen, I'm going to turn my camera on, bring the ding-a-ling and the balls.
I am not that.
You are grabbing. You were talking about like me. You
say that. I guarantee you.
Because I can see her doing that. Like, that hey, you alive? Bring the dick over here. I need to record something. I want to try this. Is your dick available or no?
Well, now there's one that like I talked to him about. Well, outside of content-wise, like, it ain't just every time we talk, we finna fuck that day.
Yeah, because it seemed like that shit would get boring, just strictly talking about fucking all day.
I don't give a fuck if they bored.
God,
that don't have nothing to do with it. They are here to serve a purpose.
Savage.
How many times do I have to say, niggas want to fuck me more than I want to fuck them? So if you want to fuck me, you are going to be in this video or you will not get no pussy from me. And that's just that. Period.
Is it really?
I'm glad I don't know nobody like that. You.
Niggas want to fuck me way more than I want to fuck them. I can go without fucking them.
You would say, is it that
fuck? It can't be, though. Like,
well, look how she's talking to grown man, fam. It got to be something in the water.
No, it's not. Because it's not like I be rude and disrespectful. Like, hey, bitch ass nigga, come bring me that dick. Y'all make it seem like I'm talking to him like that. No.
I feel like
one or two of them want you to talk
you know
to
what,
him.
What
like, I am straight to the point.
What it is a screenshot you sent me the other day. And Dog said, and he included himself into this. He said, you ain't gonna keep treating us niggas like this. Like that. That hurt me to the core. You hear me? Because not only do you know you win a rotation, but you sticking up for your brothers of the struggle.
Right. Like he stuck up for all the niggas who don't get no clock.
He stuck up for all the niggas that couldn't say it.
Like, hey, us second string niggas, we got game too.
Listen, he really sick of it, but he threw some emojis on it just to, you know, keep the peace.
Like, no,
but Dog got his own shit going on. No, listen, no one has to be here. And this takes me back to exactly.
Dog, do you hear
thank
this
you, Renee.
Shit?
They know what they're getting into from the beginning, which takes me back to the story from Wednesday that I was about to tell.
Bro, I'm listening.
You don't have to be here. Did you hear don't. That?
You don't. I don't make nobody show up and fuck me. You niggas ask. And regardless of our history, I don't give a fuck if we've been fucking off and on for 10 years. Once that OnlyFans page started, nigga, you not finna do it for nothing.
Ain't no more recreational fucking, bro.
There's no recreational fucking.
Pimp.
Yes. I'm not a pimp.
You are a pimp.
I'm not a pimp. They want something from me. I don't come
fuck
to them.
Niggas and basically make money off of them.
They don't get not a.
They don't get a red cent. You hear me?
I'm not asking them for money.
You ain't bought a nigga a bagel sandwich off no shit you made off of.
Dog, I'm not asking them for money.
You don't even feed niggas.
You don't even feed them. You ain't fried one chicken wing for none of these niggas you fuck.
You're supposed to at least find them, fuck them, and feed them.
You are a savage. You are what's wrong with this country.
Who drank a bug? Who wants to fuck who? Fill their belly.
He said you are what's wrong with this
who country. Who wants to fuck who? Okay?
You feed them after you fuck them.
Who wants to fuck who? Okay.
No, you ain't.
No, you won't. So now, since you wanted to bring it here, we here now.
Baby, I gotta go to the
When there is ass that you want to get.
Okay, wait.
Do you show up bearing gifts and shit?
We haven't had a brother sister discussion, so come on. What do you want to know?
When there is ass that you want to get, do you show up bearing gifts and shit with food and all of this kind of shit, or is you just there to drop some dick off and go?
It depended on the bitch. Truthfully.
No, Caleb.
Somebody who you just fucking
don't get a cut.
Just fucking with?
I'm just fucking them. I'm not in a fucking relationship with them. I don't fuck with them like that.
But you know these niggas because you do not fuck new niggas. They're all recycled.
She actually asked me a good question. What?
So, no, Kayla, they do not. Kayla asked, they don't get a cut. No, they do not, because niggas are not featured in my videos other than their lower half. No face, no case.
Right.
Well, so you wanted to know in 50 states.
If it was somebody
I am doing all the work. You niggas are just props to me.
God damn it.
Oh, man.
Can we get a fatality on that
They ain't no fatality. That's money, baby. Fuck all that. But so you're asking me if it was somebody I was just fucking. Clearly just fucking.
In the same situation that I am now, where
these niggas don't mean shit. They strictly content.
Now, there's one person out of the group that like we vibe outside of that, but we still only link when we're doing that.
To fuck. Right.
Because it's like, this is my thing. I am not committed to any of these niggas. These niggas are not committed to me. So you want me to be okay with you fucking all of these people while not getting anything out of it, just to be a bitch in your rotation for nothing because you want some pussy. No. If that's what you want, then you're going to make it fucking worth my while. And that's what you're doing when you get in front of this camera. Okay. You're making it worth my while to fuck with you because I don't have to. Y'all want to fuck me more than I want to fuck you. That's my whole point.
To answer your question, I did not show up bearing fucking.
I know you didn't, so shut the fuck up.
No, I didn't really. Oh, if we was just fucking, spicy. Like, if we
don't even feed him, shut up.
If we didn't even talk about nothing but fucking, or I didn't hit you until I was ready to fuck, or no shit like that, then no, I'm not feeding you or caring about nothing you got going on. Either you fucking or you ain't.
And it's like, it's not like I'm just disrespecting, oh, you bitch ass nigga, okay, just come, so, whatever, whatever. Like you no, said, but it's just. You know what? Why am I beating around the bush when you already know what our arrangement
is? Okay, so you said you got the one that you. I don't think you said you recorded him. Y'all like fuck.
Yeah.
Okay. So do you him a burrito bowl or?
Oh, we do for some wings. We have a.
Okay, so then I can respect that. Then.
Yeah,
you got the one that you will do for.
Look, he takes care of beans. He does
you
everything.
Rolled
else. It's
over
that
like a. Bitch,
I didn't. You gotta respect that, dog.
You ain't repping for the niggas. Shut the fuck up.
I don't even know the niggas, motherfucker. I'm repping for me. Period.
It didn't matter. This is a podcast. We're here to pie. You supposed to speak for the niggas who ain't got a voice, and you failed.
Okay, listen. I'll speak for the niggas who ain't.
Nah,
got
it's
the
too
voice.
Late now. You lost already.
You niggas better learn to value yourself. Because y'all letting this pink hair pimp.
I'm not pimping nobody.
Pinky.
Pinky, y'all letting Pinky.
I'm not taking no money from them.
You're making money. You're off making them. Money. You are a sex trafficker.
No, I'm not.
You are.
You like the Vince McMahon.
You are trafficking sex. You know what over the internet
for my listeners. You know what the problem is in this room. I'm the realest nigga in the room. That's the problem. I can be honest with niggas, and they can't be honest with bitches. That's why I'm under attack here.
I'm not a
guy. I do the shit that they wish that they can do, and they fucking can't. Why? Because I don't give a fuck about niggas' feelings. I don't give a fuck about telling a nigga truth when they leave me alone.
So is that the whole
I don't have to lie to keep motherfuckers around here. That's why niggas don't fuck with me.
My rebuttal?
Yeah. I'm almost in a relationship. This ain't got nothing to do with me.
That ain't my business.
Why is my technology the Vince McMahon? No,
because I just said it. He repeated it. I just said it.
Fatality.
No. As soon as you hit it, it popped up.
Bottom line, if niggas were as honest with bitches as I am with niggas, a lot of y'all wouldn't have the drama and the bullshit that y'all have. Y'all need to take some motherfucking notes and do what I do. I don't have to lie about fucking with motherfuckers. I don't have to lie about how many niggas I have in the rotation. Either you're going to be here when I call you, or I'm going to call someone else.
Sounds like the hallway. Your rebuttal, please.
Oh, my.
Basically the only one you can use at this point.
Because like I said,
talking to me, she talking to her listeners.
Because it's like I said, it's not like I just shit on niggas like, oh, you bitch ass nigga. Like, no, like, you know, it don't be on that.
Dear, yes, you do.
No, I don't.
Buddy that can't keep it up.
But him is different.
You've been killing his spirit lately.
That's different because he.
You literally told the man, like, it's. You said, listen, it's no point in fucking you. You know what that'll do to a man?
Now he's trying to pay me.
I saw that. Yeah, I'm sick of dude though.
Man, like me now too. He's trying to pay.
Like, buddy, go fuck up.
Like, I really just want another chance, bro. You got three chances when most motherfuckers don't even get that.
He irritating as fuck.
But anyway, so going back to Wednesday. So Wednesday, I hit dude. You know, tell him what I tell him, which started this whole fucking debate in the first place. And we go to link up. So I hop out the car, and you know, I got. You know, the little producer bag. I'm ready to go. So
you
I walk in.
A producer bag.
Hey man,
she producing content.
So
valid.
Because it's already everything is already packed up, ready to go.
You gotta explain.
So I get there, and you know I'm setting up, and buddy like, oh man, I ain't say we was gonna be doing all of that. Like I gotta work in the morning. I said, oh, we can do this some other time then.
I packed up and left.
He wanted to kick it.
He thought that I was just coming over to fuck. Like I'm like, what did I say about recreational sex? Like, that's not my thing. I am not here to just be giving you niggas pussy because you want to.
Just cause.
And yeah. Then just going home with a wet ass and not, you know, like, yeah. But that was nice. Felt good. I'll cherish the memory. No.
Because what if it was 3 minutes? Then you really be pissed off.
Oh, yeah. You really going to be pissed.
What's your ideal fuck time? I know you said you and buddy be like all night or whatever.
That shit crazy.
But yeah, standard time. What's your like to be like, okay, that was decent. That was all right.
Honestly, it depends on how good he is. Cause if he's not like he not really doing nothing, if that nigga nut in 5 minutes, I honestly don't care. Cause get off me. But if it's good, then you know shit. Until motherfuckers just
it
get
can
tired.
Be good for 5 minutes.
I would rather not. Like, bro, what you not finna do is
my take.
I can't take dog profile pictures.
No, don't put no more Monte fucking comments up there, man.
That nigga said he resorted to paying for.
You know you at you at the end of your rope.
Maybe he was
John said, I didn't know your pussy was gonna be that good.
Yeah, remember on Liar Liar when Jim Carrey was like beating his ass in the bathroom? Like he was at the end of his rope. He had lost it. Buddy is like
that's what dog from the dude.
Yeah, he like, man, listen, I'll pay you. I'll pay for your time. Buddy, you're not finna get none of that coochie. You might as well go on and you know.
Yeah, man, you
can subscribe and jack off to the videos or something. I don't know.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't like the way that I'm being painted here tonight.
You being what?
I don't like the way that I'm being painted here tonight. I am not a pimp.
It's only him.
You are a pimp.
I am not.
You are a sex trafficker.
I'm not.
I just called you the Vince McMahon of fucking.
When you sex traffic people, it's people that are against their will and you making them fuck other people.
Because you treat
I'm not doing that.
Okay. I won't call you a sex trafficker then, but you are a pimp.
I am not a pimp.
Because your hoes do what you want them to do, that's or they get fucked off.
That is not true.
I feel like
you're a headbutter nigga like Pimp Snooki.
No, I don't. Look.
Why'd I just watch that documentary?
He said, you think your head harder than mine? He headbutted the shit out that little.
Yeah, you like a female Fillmore Slim.
No.
He was Fillmore Slim was cold.
Now, y'all know Granny was a madam. but she and ran hoes. I'm not running hoes.
You are running hoes.
I'm not running hoes.
The only difference is you fuck your hoes. Most pimps don't.
I'm not
you
fucking my
gigolos.
Most pimps won't fuck
you.
Their
are following
hoes.
What I am doing
is using niggas for money.
What I am doing is entering into mutual arrangements with willing parties to have sex with me.
I'm not talking about the pipe a lot nigga and the stripper nigga. I'm talking about the regular nigga.
The stripper?
Yeah.
I'm talking about the regular niggas.
That's the Mr. Generous Scott.
In order
and
to
generous he is, ladies.
Pause. Thank you.
I'm talking about the regular niggas. In order to get some of whatever you got over there, they have to be on camera.
They call you a virtual gigolo.
Yes. Yeah,
that. Whoa. Who said that?
My time.
I'm not though.
We got to record some snaps.
Yeah. Poor fellas.
You can add that to that long list of introductions you give yourself.
Yeah. Virtual gigolo. No. Yeah. Panky.
Comer Walker.
A gigolo is financially supported by an older woman to be her escort or lover.
I'm sure one of them niggas older than you.
It really was a gigolo. No.
Maybe one of them niggas is older than you.
We the same age.
Mm-mm.
Look, man.
I know one of them niggas is my age.
Mm-hmm. You?
Mm-mm.
Yes, he. No, I'm wrong. You right.
I know.
Graduated 3 years after me.
You like an angry basketball coach.
What the fuck?
What? Why?
He put a motherfucker in the game and he wasn't supposed to shoot. And the first thing he do when he touched the ball is shoot. Fuck out of here, man. Like, you gotta get the fuck out, bro.
Like, so.
What the fuck was that? Right.
Do you have like a remote when you start your video? Like, you know, when you just hit the button or.
I do, but I don't like to use that because I can't see it. I like to set up first and make sure like the angle and everything is right, and then I'll record it, like I'll push the button, but because I do all my own editing stuff,
how do y'all shit start? Don't go
why'd you ask?
Don't do too much. I just want to know if it start regular.
Put some sauce on this shit,
right? And then that's
I'm
gonna
just asking if it start like
question.
Regular shit, like regular citizens do, like y'all walk up like start kissing, or do you start snake charming?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
You don't kiss these niggas?
No.
Oh, that's
kissing is really
because you have to look at what is the point of that. None of that is showing in the video, there's no point of that. If there's somebody, you know, like
I only ask that because kissing is so personal. Like I was big on not kissing the motherfucker.
No, that's not why I don't do it. It's pointless because that portion
that
wouldn't be seen anyway. You will see somebody show and you will hear.
You basically see you kissing an emoji face.
You know, but it's.
They try to kiss you?
Like when y'all in the act, niggas try to get some sugar or.
You know, okay.
You're not going to let that go?
So, one thing.
Niggas be trying to get some sugar.
And so one thing that my subscribers may have noticed, like
ain't no water.
I love back shots a lot. That's because I don't want to give eye contact and have to look in their face the entire time.
You don't want
to
press the button, you just gonna look with the stupid look.
Any day now.
You making a lot of fucking noise.
Right.
Bro.
He don't realize how. Damn. Rumbling through all this shit.
Nigga washing dishes over there.
Yeah, but
where's the sink at, Tone?
It was a noise, bruh.
He was moving plenty of silver.
Right.
Yeah, but it's not that I don't want to kiss people because I'm not going to fuck people that I wouldn't kiss.
I bet she do like back shots.
That's because you got all that back.
Didn't get shot, but
all that ass. Yeah, but I don't do it because it's like it just, it wouldn't really make sense at that point. Because I love kissing. That's a huge,
I remember you saying that before. You was a kisser, so I was wondering, like, do you do kissing in your videos or not? Because,
you know. No.
You got to like a motherfucker to kiss.
And my thing.
That's true.
As well, is with a lot of guys. As much as niggas say they know that I'm not like most bitches that they run into, it's like they don't always fully process that. So the way that I come at them is not to be disrespectful or, you know, to belittle or demean them or anything. It's to let them know that there is a clear boundary there. And you don't have to worry about Mimi being a bitch that's, oh, he's stroking me out so good. I want a relationship. No, this is strictly what it is.
So,
because every nigga, and I wrote this the other day, I feel like every nigga feels like he can stroke a bitch heart out of her chest and right onto her sleeve. And this ain't that, little daddy, at all. I'm not finna get in my feelings off.
You may not be that bitch.
Exactly. But that's why I handle shit the way that I do, to make it clear. So you don't ever have to get that little notion in that tiny little.
So,
but you back of your head. But you know, niggas are stupid.
Another thing I wanted to ask you: are your movies like scripted?
No.
Or who the fuck writing the script?
No.
Porn is scripted, bro. You may not believe it, but it is.
I didn't say that. That's porn. This is amateur.
She's doing porn though.
It ain't porn. Porn.
It is porn. Are they fucking?
Hey Juan, what's
we probably porn? Needed a script for that for that foursome though.
I knew he was coming back to that.
You want to be a script writer? Is that where you aim?
No, I'm just asking. Okay, I'm asking her, like, do you have an idea of what you want to do?
Thank you, boo.
Do you have an idea of what you want to do, like when you link up with somebody, or do you just go with it? Like, no, whatever happens.
That's whatever.
And
happens.
Then you record it.
So like, bro can't show up at the door with his dick in his hand and a pizza box.
Okay, so when I recorded the content Tuesday, before we got started.
Mimi, wait. What did you just say?
You was asking about a script. I've seen that in porno because it's scripted.
A ding-a-ling in a pizza box?
Yeah.
That's what you fucking remembered. That's what you came up with just now.
Do you want a guy dressed as a plumber like Mario?
Are you watching some wild shit, fam?
You know, go ahead, Mimi.
Or would never, you like never a guy mind. To dress like
Juan
the
is really fucked up right now. Never mind.
He probably has.
That's what I'm saying. See?
Well, okay. See? So on Tuesday, when he showed up.
With his eyebrow raised?
When he showed up. Like, it didn't have anything to do with our content, but because he had just came from a performance, I did have to take pictures of him and shit in his little cowboy outfit. So he had the double six shooter.
What?
He had the hat and the vest, and he had all his dick up, and he had the little six shooters out. Like, but it was like the toy gun. Like, you could clearly see like the orange cap on it. But he was like, you know, and I had him, and he had on the boots. And he was just,
I bet I know
on
who did
himself.
That.
He was dressed like a flying spur.
We talking about stripper, buddy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I knew it.
Yeah. But that wasn't incorporated in our scene, but you know, before we got started, I helped him out with his stuff so he could post it on his page because that was his stuff.
So the nigga had two
Why is he dressed like Yosemite Sam?
Did he have a vest on?
Yes.
You said it. So
he had a little gold star on the vest.
He had a hat, a vest, two six shooters, and some boots.
Did the hat?
That's exactly how. There was no shirt,
where
no bottoms, no nothing.
Where was
just
he going? Okay, Corral.
So. And then I had him. I'm like, all right, this would be hot. You know, get the little skyline in the background. So I had him stand on the windowsill, the hotel window, and you know, pose with his little. You know, so it was like you got two guns and then a dick pointing at you. I felt like it was creative. So, you know, I helped him out a little
That's
bit.
Funny. That's actually pretty funny.
What is wrong with you?
She got a weird ass mind, bro.
That's McMahon a fucking.
That's some freak shit.
Oh, but then he did it where it's like he had the six shooters, but he took the hat off and then he hung it on his dick. So I want to go over there and spin it.
You only fan niggas are different.
the clown nigga, he is the most different motherfucker on earth.
He be on it.
Yeah. Dog be everywhere with the clown mask on, all on the freeway fucking.
Yeah.
Broad daylight. Shout out to him.
Gotta be different. You don't put a clown mask on? But you don't like clowns, so I don't
worry. I'm scared of clowns. But I've never fucked in a mask before.
I won't. You should try it.
I should.
You're gonna suffocate.
I am, you know.
Should be hot as hell.
Oh, headed out of
town. You speak from experience?
Nigga, I used to be Chucky at Chuck E. Cheese when I was a kid, so that shit was hot.
And it's hot because, like, I sell different, like, hooded masks. I have the ones where either you can get it where it's the two eye holes and the mouth, or the eyes are fully covered and it's just the mouth hole.
I mean, I can't wear no mask no time soon. I just got my shit.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, some of the people that I deal with, like, they have, like, with them having hair, it don't work for them.
Put a bonnet on. So, I could put on a do-rag and then throw the mask on. You're right. Right. Nah, I ain't fucking these up right now.
Get you a Rey Mysterio, man.
I'm going to be a Mexican wrestler, though.
I bet Dobby fucking don't pull my hair.
Nah, bitch, don't do that. Wow. You take these motherfuckers out if we really getting at it. Like, I ain't that kind of nigga.
Yeah, whatever.
I don't be too worried about my hair.
Okay, I see you. Come on through.
You made some money?
Absolutely.
What they buy?
Now that always puts a smile on my face.
The Safari shit?
Well, apparently, somebody bought some of them.
No, this OnlyFans money. They bought another bundle subscriber. Oh, shout out to my sub from yesterday. It was like 3 o'clock in the morning, and they paid the $135.
They bought the whole year.
The what?
The $135.
You charging $135?
No. It depends on how long you get it.
To see your busty butthole, you charging $135?
No, that's for the whole year.
I thought it was 60.
No, the longer you're subscribed, the more you get up. So if you subscribe for the whole year, you get 40% off.
Mm, all right.
So, but yeah. And he's been around for where he's like, I already know I'm going to get my money worth. So shout out to him for that.
Nigga uses
what? Okay. So niggas that subscribe to OnlyFans, they just watch the videos and whack off and
there's only certain, like, I have the same handful of people that, like, actually interact with me on the site.
What do y'all talk about?
That'll like post and comment on stuff, like, because there are people who have been there since the very fucking beginning and they haven't liked a single post. Like, they always subscribe, but they don't, you know, like, they don't interact.
They closet freaks.
Do you know what it looks like when you subscribe? You not know what it looks like when you subscribe?
No, nigga, because I don't subscribe, motherfucker.
Any longer.
Right.
Mr. Tutu for school ain't finna sit here and lie in my face.
It looked like Twitter with a feed of naked bitches. No. The more naked bitches you pay for, the longer your feed gets.
Okay.
Niggas, or even if they have just
niggas be acting like they really don't know what's be going on.
Mm-hmm.
You got it, bro. You got it, bro. We need a button for that, too. That's how you got it, bro.
You spicy today, bro.
Because yeah. That's why you don't know what it looks like.
I never even said that. Like, what the fuck?
That was the question I asked you. I said, do you not know what the page looks like?
I knew she.
I thought you meant like her page.
No, don't know what her page looks like. I don't want to know what
the fuck her shit looks like, bro.
That's nasty.
I need to, because a lot of people ask. But it seems like a waste of time, sweet, because like chicks will ask me. And then I would tell them exactly what they need to do. And they use my referral link. Tell you that all of the women that came to me.
If you want some money.
Show your buns if you want some money.
All the ones came to me to help them start in OnlyFans. And I gave them like the rundown. And then they signed up for it and used my referral link. They don't do shit with those pages. In order to get paid out for referrals, period on OnlyFans, it has to be a minimum of $20 in the account. I've had $5.25 sitting in my OnlyFans for almost 2 years off of referrals because they don't do shit. So, yeah, I just stopped giving advice because I'm like, they don't fucking follow it and do anything with it anyway.
And here at TDR, we do support local businesses. So if you do start OnlyFans, and we subscribe, and that shit is terrible, I'll be first one to sit here in this chair and tell you that shit was
don't nobody want to see nobody sitting in dirty tub water rubbing their toes.
What the fuck?
Like I said, she don't need help. Just open up the page and show your butt. But I mean, even with that, it's like with marketing, you have a large following. Like a lot of people know you, so you should be fine. It's just no, like. We had a conversation earlier today, and it's like there are a lot of people that automatically assume that sex work is just like the easiest shit. in the world. And it's really not. Like, one, you have to have very, very, very thick skin in order to deal with that. Because a lot of the people that are upset because they feel like you're making your money too easy and they're not, they're the main ones that make shit hard. Like, they harass and disrespect. Like, you really got to be able to deal with that kind of shit. Me, luckily, I don't care. I tell people, you know, where to go and what to kiss and where to tip when they kiss it. But people don't be knowing.
Interesting.
What?
I like that.
Oh, people don't be knowing how much work it goes, you know, how much work goes into it. Like, you have to commit to it. You have to be consistent because, you know, there was a time where I wasn't able to be consistent because I had a lot of shit going on. And that's why I've been dropping so much content back to back lately in order to, you know, kind of to make up for that. Because like I said, I just did two videos last week that I still got to edit and get those posted and up. But prior to that, I just dropped three new videos. So I don't know. You just got to kind of learn your audience and your market. Your ass is big. Niggas always like a big oily ass. Shit, I'm a bitch and I love a big oily ass. So can't go wrong there.
Hey, oily ass on the porno.
Who's ass are you talking about?
That's on the sweet.
Oh.
She got. What is in the porn oil? Is it just regular baby oil?
I thought it was just regular oil.
I use baby oil.
That shit just look high definition. It's like it's always wet.
They
and then the way the light bounces off of it.
They be having shit in a spray bottle though. That's, they be spraying their bodies down. So like, that, is that baby oil?
As far as I know.
Hmm. Yeah, see, I thought it was some magic shit. Cause it's like it's always it's never yeah, it's it, like it never dries.
It glistens, bro. Like man, a platinum like, album. You hear me?
Yeah, but you know, you got to make sure that you know,
be to finish myself before they even start. Just watch.
You know how to entertain. It's all in the entertainment. Like people just be like, oh, I'm gonna go and I'm gonna do this.
Here
shit.
Here's the thing: he finished himself.
Fatality.
He said he finished himself. Come on, dog! Don't do that.
I'm just saying. I thought that's what we was here for.
Just say to
her. No, that's fine. Go ahead and send it.
She just told you how four niggas finished her.
Because I didn't start out with people. I started out doing all solo stuff. It was just at that point, like when people was that I used to fuck with was like trying to get back in good. I'm like, all right, well, nigga, if you want to get back on this ride, this is the price of admission.
Is Buddy from Atlanta still trying to get to you? Fella.
He was actually I don't open his messages. But he right though. Like,
put it back up. What'd he say? I didn't read it.
Bitches walking around doing nothing
in bathrobes.
He is a
choking on,
and they charge a lot to do it. Like they charge. Now, don't get me wrong. Charge whatever the fuck you want to charge. That's the whole point. It's your body. It's your page. Whatever you want to do. If you want to fucking ride around in a sweatsuit on a tricycle and charge $50 for it, if somebody paid, that's your fucking business and get your money.
You know what? I'm gonna start a page and charge as much as possible. And the video is gonna be me riding around, but people ain't gonna know that until they pay me the $50. I'm gonna give me a quick bag real fast. Well,
let me go ahead and disassociate myself with you right now.
They ain't gonna subscribe
just for the slander.
Just cause
I want to know why they're paying $50 when everybody done seen it.
Fatality.
Fatality.
That was uncalled for. That was so uncalled for, boss.
Yeah, I just.
I'm gonna charge $46.99. And there's gonna be pictures of me like riding around and then working.
Mother's on my out.
If you want to know how these, the caption on the video is gonna say, if you want to know how the sodas get to the store. I mean,
no. I'm gonna have some freak shit in the description. Make you want to
watch me stuff this 12 pack.
Yeah, like me. It's gonna be some shit like you see on porn, like
that shit was wild.
Some stepmom shit, or I fuck my neighbor's wife, something like that. But it's really just gonna be me in the car singing a Bruno Mars song. But I didn't already got your 50, so whatever.
Niggas, terrible.
You gotta buy a Versace robe at least, bro.
There's gonna be plenty of motherfucking disputes and charge, but
that's fine. Trying to I got it. Your money. It's good. Some money seen, money gone. I'm to the bank, bitch.
Yeah, but they, I don't know. I don't know. Bringing groceries and shit. Yeah, push the button.
go ahead and push it, bro.
Push the goddamn button.
Fatality.
Y'all weird, though.
Woo, when them insiders ain't too much inside.
Facts.
Y'all so crazy, bro.
Yeah, but when you start in OnlyFans, like, you really want to make sure that you are comfortable doing it. Everybody feels like they can do it until it's time to get it done.
It's time to do it.
Yep. And then, yep.
Put it on the screen. That's fact.
Like, motherfuckers probably get in front of, like, you be caring for that shit. Like, oh, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that. But as soon as that camera turned on, you probably think, like, wait, people going to see this. You might freeze up. That shit ain't for everybody, man.
Yeah, because, like, my ex, like, we've had sex 100,000 times.
He wasn't ready for that spotlight?
Wasn't ready for that spotlight.
Did he want to be in the spotlight?
That's when he came to my house to do it. He came to me. He knew what it was. Like I said, everybody knows in advance what it is.
Why do niggas sign up for this? They sign up for you to treat them like shit?
It's not treating them like shit.
Niggas is nuts.
It's not treating them like shit at all.
You might as well.
It's being upfront and honest about what my expectations are, what the arrangement is, and you have all ability to disagree with it just as much as you have to agree with it.
It's
kind
of like when you sign up.
You don't have to take the terms.
And it'd be like terms and conditions, but niggas just click.
You never read it.
Because you don't read that shit.
Yeah, you scroll and click the
book.
But you don't have to read.
There's no fine print. I'm telling you everything what it is in big bold letters.
What you're telling niggas is, listen, if you bring that ding-a-ling over here, it is going on camera.
Yeah,
and no ifs, ands, or buts.
And what kills me is when niggas think that because either we've been fucking around for so long, or because we got history, or they just feel like, you know, all right, well, I done did this portion, so now the rest is freebie.
Everything is recorded. Like, say y'all now got a 45-minute round, like champion round, and then he wants to go again. That's recorded too.
That's a whole new scene, buddy.
Hey, I ain't mad at
money
you.
Money on the wood, it's all good.
What you say?
Say money on the wood, it's all good.
Money on the wood?
Money on the wood.
Pause yourself.
But see, that's the thing. Wood, like, bro. They, like you said,
stop
niggas be
being gay.
Niggas be wanting that experience, which goes with what I said. They want to fuck me more than I want to fuck them, and that's why things are the way that they are.
Yeah, I respect it.
I'm not trying to dog niggas out. I'm not trying to shit on them. I'm not nothing. I'm just saying
you are
that
shitting on them.
I'm
the
not
way
though.
You talk to them. You told Buddy it wasn't worth it.
That's because
that's
it wasn't.
Whole grown man though.
That because it's not worth it.
Okay,
it's not
you don't
worth
have
my
to
wife.
Tell him that though.
What the fuck you?
You
mean?
Could just be like, I'm good, bro.
He don't understand what me telling him the way I'm telling him. So how you think
you
he
know,
was gonna understand
you know,
if I was
you
nice?
Know why you an asshole? Because you won't block him.
You
block the nigga that you can have all
no.
night, all weeks. No,
the reason,
no,
no,
no. Wait, no.
No, the no, reason no, 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 I don't no. block him is because I don't trust him. And I feel like once he know he blocked, he gonna try to post some shit that we already had an agreement on that he couldn't post because he don't
break an
post
NDA.
Some shit like what? Is he an OnlyFans nigga?
We got here breaking NDAs.
He's a horrible one.
He's an OnlyFans nigga though, right?
Well, he was trying to be, but I think I kind of broke that.
You fucked his career off?
Yeah, it is. But
you damn, will block. You will block. You will block the nigga that you can have marathon sex with, but won't block Vine video dick.
I just told you why.
Ah, I see what you did there.
No, because with what I post, he's not. He's not visible in the video. But I feel like, oh well, she can't see this anyway. Well, I'm finna start sharing this and promoting myself with it, and I don't trust that. So that's why I don't block him. That's literally the only reason why.
You just want us to whoop his ass?
Right. So, that's easy.
All
right. I mean, I could do that.
I ain't stabbed a nigga in a long time.
I'm more aggressive
what's
than
what
y'all.
What's with the...
I said that.
Yeah, out loud, bro. Damn.
Whoops.
I'm just inviting him to some hands. Now, whatever happened
yeah,
after
and that's,
that?
And that's a big thing, too. Like, I want y'all to, like, before y'all start subscribing to Chicks OnlyFans, check their other social media pages. Like, a lot of times, they will just take the same shit that they are posting on Instagram and Facebook and everything else, and then they'll put that on OnlyFans and want you to pay for it. So you can kind of gauge on how freaky a bitch is or not. Sometimes you can't. They will surprise you. And sometimes you get what you know what you're getting. But just kind of be wary of that when you're looking at chicks' pages. Look at the number of posts and shit they got too. You're like, damn, all right, she whacking, you know, 25 a month. But you I see this motherfucker posts. Only got, you know, like two posts and shit.
Yeah.
Two posts and six likes, but I'm supposed to drop 25.
Hey, because the twerk team definitely was charging 50. And I'm like, well, I don't know what you motherfuckers do.
Yeah. Man. Who's the twerk team?
Some bitches that got
that just be twerking.
But the naked twerk might be cold.
You can just watch Cardi B video with the city girls.
Yeah, they was
bad. They was.
Yeah, so yeah, she said, is it better to show your face or not show your face? Baby, that all depends on you and how comfortable you are. I was going to do the whole mask thing or just like, you know, from the neck chest down or whatever, but I'm like, I'm me, so I really don't care. And honestly, for me, which I feel would probably be the same thing for you, with people knowing that is you, you probably get more subscribers because that's how it worked for me. Like, people knowing that it was me, then before I even really got started, motherfuckers was tap, 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 tap because they had been waiting anyway.
We want to see your face. Show your face.
Yeah, so that depends on you and how comfortable you are doing it. Like, if you don't mind your face being in those videos, or shit, you don't have to show your face all the time. Like, depending on the type of content it is, maybe you don't want to show your face.
That's a lot of pain.
Buddy said 35
pages. I know. I get it. They are free. But that's an excessive amount.
I unfollowed that one bitch because even though her shit was free, like, she was DMing like every fucking right, like every 20 minutes. Hey, her pay to unlock this bitch? No.
So her page is free, but then she charged you to pay to unlock some shit.
Yeah. That's how it works. That's how they don't do everything for you. Like, they, so you can get like little clips or certain or shit that may already be viral.
Like appetizers.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, so when people see mine, they be like, "Dang, that's kind of high," when it's really not. I should be charging y'all more, but
I'm surprised you don't charge the max.
But with the amount of subscribers that I get, I like to keep it kind of like me.
You might could get the 50 ball.
You might can get the 50 ball.
I just especially because I don't charge pay per view to unlock videos. So once you subscribe to mine, everything that I have going back from the very beginning is right there on the feed.
I think
you don't have to unlock anything.
I think if you charge the 50 ball, you probably
get I think if you charge the 50,
probably get more yearly subscribers just so it knocks some off that price.
Yeah, you get the 50.
Yeah. So
cuz like you said, you know, niggas want to fuck you more than want to fuck them.
Heard it you to say that, didn't it?
Mm-hmm.
I feel.
What is wrong with your brother,
you see,
bro?
You see how the last
it's up there.
You needy whore.
You needy whore.
Yeah, that was the last one that y'all posted in the group.
Say hi, bro.
Gotta be.
And I was like, nah, every time, bro, and it kept going. I'm like, she was sending way too many messages, and I'm like, I'll unfollow.
She premiere?
I don't know. I don't know.
It just premiere be needy. That's why.
Test through, young man.
Yeah.
Test through.
So.
Yeah. I knew he was. He was off of edible. I knew he was high.
Man, I'm telling you, I was so like.
Are you horny, daddy?
That's so weird. I make you run?
That's so weird, bro.
Run there.
Yeah, I couldn't do it. I don't know. I've been thinking about like price structure though. Like, do I want to do the bait and switch again? Like, lower it and just get more subs, and then all right, y'all finna pay for
this,
all of this shit.
Yeah,
this
your world.
Me blowing this balloon up.
Yeah, but I just, for me, honestly, I like having it at a higher price because the cheap niggas that like don't be trying to tip and do all that shit anyway, like, kind of keeping them out of them.
Okay, do niggas be on they Myron shit? Like, do this or I want to see that type shit? Like, they send you messages like, do a video doing this.
I do get some people, but for the most part, they know, like, if you have a special request, you're going to pay me for it.
No, that's what I'm asking. Like, do niggas have special requests is what I'm asking.
Yeah. So they can pay for, like, personalized videos where, like, I'll say their name as I'm coming and stuff, like, to make them. You asked, bro. You asked.
You did.
You asked. You asked. So they can pay me for personalized videos that way. So they love those, though, with me saying their name. So that's like my biggest request, like doing like masturbation videos and like because it's personalized. Like,
is it really?
It keeps, yeah.
Well, I don't
know. It is. It's personalized because it's it's their name. I'm talking to them while I'm doing myself, and they like that. So it is what it is.
I don't know, man. You can do a lot with some video editing equipment.
She told us before.
I'm gonna slap the fuck out of both of y'all.
What? I wasn't talking about you specifically. Do you feel guilty?
No.
All right, then. Shut up.
Y'all just annoying.
No. I ain't said nothing.
Monte out here calling people needy whores if we annoying.
That's true, though, because I was a victim of it, so I agree with
that. And nobody likes the pushy stripper.
No, they don't.
I hate the pushy stripper. You want to tip me for my dance? Bitch, I'm in at this bar.
The pushy strippers be the ones that don't even do nothing.
Right. You want to give me a dollar?
They just walk around.
The fuck did you do? You ain't see my dance? No, bitch. I've been at this bar.
Yeah, but I really want y'all to, like, if you start an OnlyFans, please do it the right way. And by right way, I mean, like, make it fun. Make it entertaining. Don't just go in there and be like, oh, I'm finna dance around in a t-shirt. Because that goes around a lot in Milwaukee. Like, y'all don't really know how to entertain.
Wait, bitches just be out here dancing in t-shirts?
Just Winnie the Pooh in it.
Bro, no, I'm not paying $750 for that.
What are we talking about?
That's what I like.
We don't know what you like. We don't press the button.
I was reading it. Yeah, see? That's what I like to hear. That's my type.
No bells, no whistles for that. That admission of life.
Gotta get your groove on.
Shut up. She won't be a slut. She can be a slut.
Hey, we need to interview somebody that sell pussy. Not to judge, because y'all. No. Not to judge. Because y'all know I don't do that. And get your coin how you get your coin. I want to talk to them to ask, like, how do you come up with your pricing sheet? Like,
that's a valid question.
Yeah.
So you think real whores got like office Excel?
Like, I want to know, like, is put like, do they really be charging a 40 or do they charge some other shit?
Ask, do hoes be having QuickBook?
I mean, if you got a price,
I got the app on mine. QuickBook self-employed right on the iPad. Sheet,
you know, well,
spreadsheet for spreading cheeks. You got a whole little right. Yeah.
You do your pricing numbers. Maybe your numbers go down in the month of July.
I can just buy you out of it.
I thought everybody what the fuck?
No. Okay, so being on Twitter, I can tell you that a lot of Milwaukee chicks definitely charge $40.
Who are they only fans
now?
For OnlyFans or for Coochie?
No, for Coochie.
Really?
They do is what's called a meetup. Right? Yeah.
Yeah, Coochie is
so
really
they're like
cheap,
meetups.
No, I know you fucking lie.
No, no bullshit. They're like meetups, $40, blah 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 blah.
Is the initial fee 40 and then it's more, or is it
that's what I'm that's why I want to interview somebody that sell it, because I want to know, like, okay, is 40 the base rate, but then, you know, if you want to throw in the bells and whistles, then it's extra.
Do it go up every half hour or what?
Right, that's why I want to talk to somebody and ask them, because I really want to know how that goes.
$50 for an hour.
If you lick a nigga parking space, is it an extra 15?
Because like niggas try to buy coochie on OnlyFans all the time, and I've never had anybody say, "Oh, well, $40." They always start at $200. Even for me, I feel like that's low. Like, so you just. I don't know. $200 just it don't seem.
Yeah, I heard in Vegas, motherfuckers is charging $1,000 to fuck. So
I believe
them
it.
Them prices need to come on up.
Yeah, but they do $40 meetups.
But then you know,
I'm like $200, bro. Like that don't pay my Verizon bill. But
what don't pay your Verizon bill?
$200.
No, it don't pay nobody phone bill.
So yeah, I don't. I'd never understood that.
So.
And I couldn't ask my granny when she was alive because, you know, bitches was selling pussy for a nickel back then.
Pussy was real cheap.
What's your home price, though?
I don't know.
Okay, so if you was to sell coochie.
I just asked her that. I think I said, what's your home price? Yeah. Did you miss the question?
I wasn't going to say whole price. If you was to sell some, what would you sell it for?
I have no idea, honestly.
I don't care.
No.
I asked it better. I don't care.
I'm going to be 100% honest and say right now that I don't think that I would know my price until I heard it.
Oh, so you would let the nigga jump out the window first, like, I get you $45,000 right now. Sold.
Yeah.
Bring it on, nigga.
But it ain't going to be no, you know, like,
are you going to give him?
Like, no.
You know what? I'm not going to ask that question. Never mind.
Or like, you know, like, I just. I'm not going to ask that. I feel like if when he throw that amount out there, if my coochie don't jump, nipples park up a little bit, then it ain't enough.
Remember in Diesel Proposal when Buddy said, I give you $1 million to sleep with your wife?
Oh, she said 125 now? Because she was definitely one of the ones who was talking about some $40 meetups. Maybe she had a bad experience or it was inflation or some shit.
So, bro, do you have a whole price?
Yes, I do.
How much is your whole price?
None of your fucking business.
PlayStation?
Mm-mm, I don't play PlayStation.
And it's about the same amount.
No. I don't know, man.
So, like, bitch can't walk. Like, you don't have a set number. If a chick walked up, it's either yay or it's nay.
She thick as fuck. She just looks slow, and that's definitely
I'm gonna need some money though, just in case a bitch tells somebody.
So she walk up right now.
That money got to be worth me.
She got $500 cash.
$500
cash. Are you fucking or are you not fucking?
Gotta get your groove.
So we know bro can be bought for an easy $500.
It ain't gonna be. You ain't gonna get $500 worth though. I'm get you out of there in 5 minutes.
I hope she makes.
But see, okay, Cocktail Prime. We saw how expensive that was, right?
Right.
I had a guy.
You know what? No, $500 ain't enough. She bought a toy for $500.
Like,
that's her though. We talking right, about
but,
you.
But I had the someone.
Fuck, my shit ain't weak, nigga.
But I had somebody.
Pause. I don't.
But $500 ain't even really.
But
that
I
ain't even rent
but
really,
I had
bro.
Before I bought it myself, I had somebody offering to buy that for me just for, you know, the experience with me. And it was like, even then, it was just I couldn't get myself to do it.
Yeah, I don't know if 500.
So I did. I just I ended up buying it myself. 500
ain't gonna stop you from getting killed, really.
Tom, do you have a home price? Yep.
$27. And a six pack of Michelob Light,
whatever that camera costs. We...
Michelob, what?
Tony, you fucking for Michelob?
Some Saint Ives, Pina Colada.
She said Mondays are made for Michelob.
I mean, but it's a Tuesday. Fly me out, I'm going. So
say what?
If you fly me out, I'm going. So it don't matter.
So they pay for the flight, didn't pay you.
Yeah.
So really. All I gotta do is fly you out and fuck you for free.
Yeah, you flew me out, got me out this.
So you don't have a price then?
Well, technically, if that plane ticket is like $100, that's what he was going for. Mm-hmm. Fucking for plane tickets.
I didn't see plane tickets.
Oh, the Southwest low fare rate special that got going.
Yeah, Southwest always got shit for $59.
$59 round trip. Tone is fucking.
I'm just saying. Give me out the
seat. I respect
because I definitely went to ATL for $82.
You just a freak,
after
man.
Taxes and fees.
I mean, do she at least got the world?
She at least
got to
buy you lunch. She got feed you at least, right?
Oh, you know what?
Food is required.
Since he said you know fly out and he fucking, I guess my price is $100.
I gave him $500. He was like, "Well, I'd have been food, man." This
I'm out of here in a minute.
$400
Yeah. You know what?
$400 and a meal.
Hey, you know what? I think for women, my price would actually be lower, though.
Yeah, I mean, you actually so like females, but niggas just you know them pissed you off over the years. You know.
It's not even that; they just be sexually fucking disappointed because they gas the fuck out of theyself, and then you get it, and it's like, this is what you bitches be subbing back and forth on Facebook over.
Yeah.
Oh.
Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
No. This.
Mm-hmm.
This.
Yeah,
accidentally liking your post.
Like, what is this?
Not on your friends list and accidentally liking
you said,
your
what
staff.
Is this?
Like, bitch, return the sender, and I don't care which one of you motherfuckers signed for the package. Like,
this is your king?
Is this your king?
It ain't King Dingaling, that's for sure.
Ouch!
Did you come back from the dead like T'Challa though?
Yeah, right now my price is $100.
I just want to get fluid out. I'm trying to see all.
Okay, so someone gave her 600 for the 3-way.
Okay, so now
600 ain't bad.
I feel like she probably would have did it just cause.
So, okay, so maybe like now, is it specifically just pricing, or is it favors as well? Because certain things might be more important, even though they don't cost as much as like what your flat rate would be, I guess.
I think it depends on the person that's offering the money too.
What's a favor?
Hmm.
Is that favors?
Yeah. What's like depend like depending on like something that you, like you really really need at the moment.
So like if you need like some medication and a phone stop at the pharmacy for you type favor or
what?
Yeah, EpiPens is expensive, bro. Yeah,
pay your electric. Right, that's,
EpiPens is kind of high.
Are you trading pussy for the electric bill? Like where are we at with it?
No, like, niggas, I think if you niggas were disappointing way before I got Coctimus Prime. That's how Coctimus Prime even came into play, because Coctimus Prime is consistent and I can control it.
Because I could probably be bought for a pair of kicks.
We know.
I think if
nigga, you could be not bought really, for fucking chicken tenders and fries.
I think if you're not really attracted to the person, you need to add some money onto that's that. You need to pay me a little bit more.
See, and I think that's my biggest thing that stops me like from, because like I said, I don't knock anybody for selling pussy at all, like not even a little bit, but I think that's what stops me, because it's like fucking with people that I'm not really attracted to.
You got to go through a whole lot.
That's
to
no
fuck, to fuck through that you got to go
yeah
through a whole
and
lot.
It's just like I'm not trying to be, you know, waiting to exhale, you know, not right. Waiting to exhale, set it off, sorry, you know, when Nate was just up there sweating on her and
bro,
shit.
That scene is very disturbing.
That was in
still,
bro. Too.
Yeah.
That whole, like,
just that whole interaction.
Yeah,
like,
but she
he
did
was,
it because she was in the bind to help her brother. Right. You know how, dog, I'd have burnt that whole police station down. I had to fuck this nigga for this money for my brother, and then you killed him.
The last, when he looked at her right before that scene, like, that was the dirtiest, some of the nastiest shit I've ever seen in my life. Like, you a filthy, nasty old man.
Fair exchange, no rubber.
Yeah, gross.
That's a good market, like for you doing a lot of girl on girl, because a lot of chicks don't do it, or when they do it, they don't fucking be attractive. Because there's a lot of chicks on Twitter that I see, and it's like
the rubber and fast sex story I told. She I'm definitely like, would have had to pay extra, boss. I'm I like, feel like she owed me some money.
Should see if you can collect.
No, I'm straight. She did.
Like, wait. She dead to you or like she?
Yeah,
dead
like dead to me. Oh, like, I don't know if she dead or alive or not, nigga.
He said it so casual, like, nah, fuck, she dead.
Nah, he could have just said that's dead, like the situation.
I didn't mean. Like, sorry, whoops. I don't know.
That's who terrible, bro. Cares?
Somebody cares,
right?
Somebody loves that young
man. Not me.
You're a heartless individual.
Right, but he's sitting here getting on my ass just because I won't let people fuck me for, you know,
would
for
you
fun.
Fuck me for free?
But you should actually. Right, in the same niggas that was sitting around here dancing and skipping the Drake talking about some, they shouldn't have to fuck for free. Why are you looking at me like that?
We didn't tell you to fuck for free. We just don't like the way you talk to
who
people.
Who in this room said you should fuck for free?
Y'all talking to me like I'm a bad
no,
guy.
No, I just no, said no, you kind of. You kind of rough.
Right.
I'm not rough. I'm.
You talk
you don't
to
make,
like you scarf.
You don't make them feel good.
I feel like
I do make
but,
them feel
no,
good.
Before you fuck, you do not make them
I
feel
I make
good.
Them feel plenty good, which is why they keep trying to get in this motherfucker.
You talk to niggas like you raise a Ramon. I'm pretty sure you just shoot.
I don't.
Hey, yo.
Chico.
That's just,
get
bro.
The
like, get the work.
Bro.
What was
it? Gotta relax.
What was the pimp, Kenny Red? Dog said, come here, you funky bitch. That's how you talk to
them. That's definitely
niggas.
Not how I talk to them at all.
Not
all.
Not
at all.
Come here, you funky bitch.
That is not how I talk to niggas at all. Not even close.
I seen him do it at Park Bar. He was mad as a motherfucker.
Mimi talks to him saucy and shit. Like, come here, baby. You got a job to do.
You got a job to do. And you better come do it.
Bro, that is not how this
you
works.
You better make that motherfucker stand up as long
niggas
as I need to.
Niggas be on pins and needles when they see that text message.
You got 30 minutes
that's
to make
intimidating.
That.
I told you a few shows ago. You was intimidating, man.
That's not intimidating. niggas love bitches that just want to fuck and don't want strings attached. But then when I do it, I'm the bad guy? How?
You making a nigga nut in 3 minutes. He ain't enjoying no sex.
Yo, you walk in the door and you automatically pop a pill in his mouth, don't you?
No.
I ain't got time to worry
about it. An hour for the pill to work.
Hey, when you send your text messages, I bet niggas had that moment where shit get cloudy and then it's like, who wants to be a millionaire? They got like three options.
It's kind of like when you get some good pussy for the first time and your shit won't jump up. You probably make niggas feel like that every time.
Mm.
Like, listen, I'm finna pull up. I'm finna record some content. Don't embarrass me. Great.
Look.
Yeah, well, you tell the motherfucker, don't embarrass
me. Yeah, don't embarrass
me. They're gonna do some
other shit. Like, what?
They are fucking more than just me, okay? They don't have to be here. How many times do I have to say that?
But it's different.
I don't force them to be here. So they know what the terms are. So why am I wrong for setting those terms?
But they used to dictate in the show. Like, were you fucking other bitches? Like, I tell you what to do, when to do it, how to do it, because I'm the nigga. But you the nigga. So you talk to them like they the bitch.
You slap them on their chest, don't you?
You probably you be slapping niggas on their ass, don't you? Good guy.
Nigga gang.
I have.
I have. That work you put in. I see.
Because dudes' booties be like shaped so perfect with no effort at all. Oh, I hate that. We got to do squats and all this shit.
I got to go get the babies.
And niggas be having this strong, chiseled ass cheeks. But no, don't let them make it seem like I'm just this horrible person.
Sweet. Stop encouraging me.
And please. I'm just going to hit niggas up like, hey, you slut ass nigga, come let me fuck you on this camera. That's not how I do stuff.
I feel like you've said that to
That's
a nigga.
Not how
Maybe
I do
that stuff. One dude, you talk to him that way. But...
You slut ass nigga.
That's not how I talk to niggas at all. What I do,
with the eye emojis?
Like, I asked him, like, all right, you trying to link or what? Like, but if we linking, like, you already know.
Damn, you don't ask this nigga you want something to eat.
She told what you she don't eat like, eat before you get here.
All right, man.
I mean, you don't feed bitches, so, I mean.
No, I didn't.
Okay, maybe this will put things a little bit in perspective, okay, on why I operate the way that I do. And, you know, why I talk the way that I do and why niggas are not compensated. When I say, like, I do all. The work. I am actually the one getting the short end of the stick in his videos, but I get compensated. But I get compensated for it in the end. During sex, I am not compensated for it. You want to know why? Because I am not putting niggas' faces in videos. Now, if I am going to post a video of me getting chewed, what is the point of that? If there's a whole emoji over a face in my pussy, you can't see that, right?
Even in the real video, you got emoji over it?
No, what I'm saying is that would be pointless for me to do that. So
put the GoPro on a nigga neck.
She got the headband one.
You can still probably see the face though.
Yeah.
So if you put the GoPro on a nigga neck, it's tongue and butthole or whatever the fuck you down there eating.
Yeah.
Just the undercarriage.
Yeah, your undercarriage, your gooch. Gooch Cam.
Hey, is that the name of this episode? Gooch Cam.
Yeah. So when you see coochie eating on my OnlyFans, it's women. So I don't even have them do that because I don't want to go through the whole process of editing it in order to have to take their face out and everything else. So that's already one thing that
Why
you're getting away with.
Face out?
Huh?
Why do they need their face out?
Because I don't put niggas' faces on my OnlyFans.
You don't
want
to cut the check.
I thought you were talking about the women.
You feel like you feel like you got to pay them if they faces?
No, I just, I don't want people on there. Like,
so, okay.
I
so
put them on there how I put them on there. The only people that are on there are the ones with OnlyFans.
Oh, yeah. See, I was going to ask that. So, like, we use other content creators.
Right.
Do they get to have
civilians are anonymous.
Got it. Makes sense.
Yeah. Civilians.
Yeah. Civilians are anonymous. But other content creators, y'all. So that's one thing. Like, you know, I'm not making you, you know, give me head and all this shit on camera. Like, you get to skip that part. So that's already one luxury that you get that I shouldn't even be fucking you because I'm not getting everything that I'm used to getting. But because I'm compensated in the end for it, I let it slide. So that's one thing.
She charging 90 for some top?
Who?
I'm reading the group chat.
$90 per head
in the group chat.
The chick Monte talking about.
Oh,
who was charging $100? So it was $150 for the pussy, but it's $90 for the head.
Oh, so he's showing her her price list. My meetups price list: camera action $300, no camera $200, just head 20 to 30 minutes $90, only pussy no head $150.
First of all,
I don't do anal. I repeat, I don't do anal.
I'm not sitting there for 30 minutes ahead anyway. You got about 12 to 17 minutes. Suck me down and be done. 30 minutes ahead?
Oh, yeah. See, the women be cool, so I don't be having to worry about that.
Who can sit through 30 minutes ahead?
So
maybe you get multiple nuts.
Yeah.
One and done?
One and done. A nut off head is different than a nut off, you know, the devil's doorbell.
I draw mine out purposely.
A nut off one, head because making shit real tender.
Content wise, I don't want no fucking, you know, 2 minute video. And plus I'm real. I guess I'm real dominant. So I'm petty and I like to see niggas squirm.
You believe so?
I mean, a little bit, possibly.
Talking to niggas like you, Hulk Hogan, that shit.
Bro, I don't.
Like, do you be hitting niggas in your videos?
No, man.
Them all that shit? Making them kiss your boot heel?
No.
Boot heel?
Oh, you got chill.
Just
kicking them in the nuts and shit? Like
no.
Man, you turn our sister a dominatrix, bro?
She says she's dominant, bro.
You got another outfit with the mask that zip over the mouth?
Look, all I'm saying is.
You ever seen Billions?
It is not.
She burned my nigga fault. With a cigarette.
People know what they sign up for. They have an opportunity to say no.
That's what you want to do?
But if you want something bad enough, you are going to say yes. And they say yes because they want it bad enough. So here we are. Now get off my fucking back. So anyway, I want to thank you guys for tuning in to this week's episode of Hostially Awkward, even though I spent most of this episode under attack for absolutely no fucking reason.
That's what I'm changing the name of the episode to, Under Attack.
That's how I feel.
That was Maul.
What?
Huh?
I didn't attack her.
A little bit.
Kayla, I don't like dudes that like dick. They get on my nerves.
Wait, who like what?
No, she said, but you are a great actor because in the videos, you really think you like these dudes. Because it's like, I can't fuck people that I don't like, absolutely what? Just can't stand. Like, just come on, let's get it over with. That's why I can't sell pussy.
She be watching you for your acting?
So I do have a good enough vibe with them maybe to where like, when we are interacting sexually, there's no weirdness or awkwardness or like, damn, man, you could tell she really don't want to be there. Hmm. Shut up. But yeah, so that's why. So with the dudes who I create content with, like I said, most of them are recycled. Like, these are niggas who have been around for a long time. I have a history with them. So for the most part, the dudes that are in the videos, like, I do actually have a bond with them. It's just, this ain't that for y'all to just call me and get pussy whenever y'all feel like it, because
do y'all go like Dave and Buster's and shit?
No.
And kick it?
No. No.
Ain't no dates. No. They just fucking.
The only one that I go on dates with is the one that I'm not recording with.
The niggas like that's got OnlyFans too. Like, do y'all like hang out? Like, y'all.
No, not outside of content.
No shit like
y'all
that?
Have an OnlyFans kickback.
No.
Basically, that's what I was asking. Like, no. Are y'all cool?
That's just an origin, ain't it?
Like, we could, like, with
what I mean is
like with D, like the one, the cowboy.
Could cowboy had call you like, hey bro,
like we text and shit.
Yeah, like, so,
like we talk outside of that.
Let's go hoop or something. Not hoop, but.
but like he'll hit me and he'll, you know, like, how was your day, you know, whatever.
That's what I mean.
And,
like,
you know, like, or like when my granny passed, like, you know, he checked on me and shit like that. But then it's mostly like, you at work, you got them titties out, like, you know. It go that way sometimes. But it ain't always, you know, it ain't always content conversation.
Well, if a nigga hits you up,
you definitely didn't have to tell me Desperado be asking about your titties.
Yes.
Let's go hoop.
He sucks titties like his life depends on it. I know I made a post and I said niggas don't be sucking titties no more. I meant that shit. Niggas don't be sucking titties no more. Some do exist because I had a nigga, he had his... got his motherfucking teeth snatched out of his mouth, and that nigga still gauze and all was trying to slide on him. But you niggas really need to start back sucking titties. That's very important. So again, I'm going to thank you guys for tuning in to this week's episode. I'm going to go ahead and get out of here because I am hungry and I have more alcohol to consume. Make sure if you are not subscribed to OnlyFans, you go ahead and get your ass over there. Like I said, I just dropped 3 new videos. And one of those videos, I actually have an alternate angle coming. So I will be posting that as well because I set up multiple cameras. I had a GoPro camera strapped up to them. And then I have my ring light with my cell phone recording. So y'all will get that one as well. And then I still have the 2 videos from last week, including the foursome that are coming. So make sure you subscribe, onlyfans.com/cummer_walker. Make sure you also shop cummerscandycloset.com for all of your sex toy and lingerie needs, whatever you need. I got it, and if I don't got it, I can get it. So make sure that you know that anything I have on that website, if it does not say sold out, and it is not a sex chair or a fuck machine, you can get it that day. I keep all of my own inventory, so you don't have to wait for me to drop ship. You don't got to wait for me to, you know, get the shit from China and 60 to 90 days before I get it to you. I keep all of my own shit ready to go. I am my own fucking warehouse around here. All right. So until next time, we got to go.